And we're not allowed to have a favorite worship leader because we're supposed to love them all equally. But you know I love you so much, and I feel your heart and your emotion. What I'd love to do to our church family and from people from anywhere is invite you just to join us in praying. Pastor Herbert and Tiffany, before we do that, how can we pray for you and the ministry at People's Church?
I would ask that you would pray that during this time where so much injustice is felt, that you would pray that as leaders that we would have wisdom, the leaders of this city would have wisdom, that we would come together in conversation and understanding, that we would all have a posture of humility, that as there's so much pain in our world, that we can come together with the hope of Jesus Christ.
And I would say, you know, I'm having conversations with, you know, people in our church, and they're are people hurting? You know, I know I'm hurting the pain and the conversations I'm having with my children, my boys. And I had one of our tenders today, one of the black men in our church, text me today and said, "Pastor, I never thought I'd be trying to have these conversations, answer these questions with my kids." And so, man, just prayer for, you know, wisdom in the pain of people. So I just think it's real, and people are really processing at a much deeper level. And no matter their skin color, there's a lot of processing and pain and hurt that we just need to just to pray for our church and really for all churches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I want to tell you thank you. I mean, you've been a dear friend, and you've helped me to understand in a way that we just wouldn't share the same perspective as so many people. And you know, after talking to you and a lot of other friends at our church, we're putting our series on pause, and we're going to talk directly about this weekend. And I just want to say thank you to you personally for helping me to better understand and have the words to at least to attempt to try to make a difference. And so we're going to do that. And what I'd love to do is not people came to pray, so I want to pray. Pastor, I'll ask you to lead off, and then I'll ask Tiffany to pray, and then I'll pray, and then I'll let the one with the great faith bring it home, and then I'll say a few words. And just to our church family, just join us from wherever you are. If you've got a need for physical healing, we're going to believe God's going to touch your need. If COVID has made it difficult on you financially, we're going to pray for that. And especially to all of you who are grieving with real injustices in the world, we want you to know that even if we don't understand completely, we do care so much. We do care so much. And so, Pastor, thank you for your faith, and would you lead us in prayer?
Yes. Heavenly Father, we come to you, and I know from your word, I know from the Bible, that one of the tools of the devil is division. Is disunity, yeah. Is hatred. Lord, I know the devil right now is sitting back laughing and hoping that the church starts to operate with weapons of hatred and division, and we separate instead of pull together. And Father, I pray right now that you would fill our hearts with love, whether we're red, yellow, black, or white. God, I pray that you would help the Church of Jesus Christ to unify right now. Lord, I come against every attack of the enemy on our nation that's trying to drive a wedge of division, that's trying to cause us to hate each other, that's trying to cause the blacks to hate police and police to hate blacks, and trying to drive a wedge between different races. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you would move by your Holy Spirit, you would pour out peace. You're the God of peace. You're the God of hope. You're the God of love, and we're calling on you today, Lord, to pour out your Spirit and fill our hearts with love and peace and joy. And God, I pray that your church would be the answer. Lord, I pray we would rise up in these last days, and we would lead the way. Your word says in John 13, Lord, that they would know us, that the world would know us by our love for one another. Fill our hearts with your love and let the world take their cues from the church in these days. I just pray that, God, unity, Lord, bind us together in your love so that we can make a difference and see meaningful change, I pray, in Jesus' name.
Father, we lift up the family of George Floyd, who has lost him so tragically. Father, we pray, God, for those who call him son, for those who call him father, for those who are his friends, God. We pray for a nation that is hurting and grieving over the senseless loss of his life. And Father, you say in Psalm 34:18 that you are near, you are close to the brokenhearted. So Father, we pray for those who are broken hearted. We pray for those who are grieving, who feel inconsolable in their pain. God, would you be near to them, Father? Would your spirit comfort them? Would you come and surround them in their brokenness, Father? God, we ask for not only your comfort, but your peace, Father. A peace that surpasses our understanding, God, in a nation that is hurting, in a nation that is grieving, Father, would you come in your power by your Spirit? Would you come to comfort? Would you surround us with your peace, Father? Would the tragic loss of George's life, God, not be in vain, but would it be for change, Father? We pray comfort, we ask. Bring peace, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes, Lord, I agree. And just pray even more, God, for comfort, for healing. I pray, God, for all those that are even watching right now that are hurting in any measure. May the peace that goes beyond our human ability to understand, God, guard their hearts and their minds in Christ Jesus. We pray, God, for Pastor Herbert and Tiffany and for People's Church, God, that you would bless and strengthen their church, their people, God. We pray for unity amongst all of our churches, that the world would see us, that we'd be the answer to Jesus' prayer in John 17, that we'd be one. God, I pray for our church, that you would give us compassion, understanding, God, a heart for justice and a heart to make your heart known. God, give us a divine love for all people, God, and especially right now, give us a compassion to really, really show your heart and our heart to those who've been hurt by racism. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that your church would be unified, that the name of Jesus would be lifted up, God, that you'd bring healing where there's hurting. God, provide for those who are going without. And God, we thank you that you're a God to whom all things are possible. We pray for miracles. God, we believe by faith that you'll hear our prayer, and we will be a part of your change on this earth as it is in heaven.
Yes, amen. Heavenly Father, we look to you and we cry out to you and say, thank you that you're helper. Thank you that you're healer. Thank you that you're the answer, the source, and the sustainer. Jesus, I pray that you would draw all men to you during this time, that you would be made known through the crisis and the tragedy, that you would use your church to be that light of love, to draw people to your name. Father, we pray that you would heal our land. And so, Father, we humble ourselves and we repent and we turn from, as a nation and as individuals, from our wicked ways. We turn from looking down on others. We turn from injustices, and we turn from pride, and we turn from hate. Forgive us, Jesus, forgive us. We humble ourselves and we ask this, that you would heal our land. We pray that you would heal our hearts. We thank you, Father, that you are with us as a church. We thank you that you are working. We do not lose hope. You are the living hope. And so we praise you in these things. We thank you that we can always go before you. We thank you that, Lord, when we don't know what to pray, that you are interceding for us. Father, you have us. You have our neighbors, our black neighbors, our neighbors of all colors, the neighbors of all nations. You have us. And we thank you for your mighty love. And we pray these things in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
To all of our church family, I pray that you will both pray and act. Prayer is powerful. And Amy even alluded to the verse that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, if they'll seek my face, if they'll turn from their wicked ways, God says, I will hear their prayers. I'll heal their land. And that's what we're asking for. I would encourage you even to pray where you are. If you've got friends close by, life group, family members, just continue to pray. And then we're also going to act. One of the things we can do in a time like this is we can worship. And our team wrote a song, Get Ready to Feel the Emotion, because the song's called Heaven's All Around Us. And that's the truth. We're surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. The presence of God is here. He is real. He is the comforter. He is the healer. He is our, we all feel your emotion. And Amy and I love you, your family so much. And Pastor Herbert, Pastor Tiffany, there's no way we could ever express our love for you enough. We're honored to have you friends. We're honored that you're in our city. And to our church, we love you. And we thank you for spending a little bit of time in prayer. Let's continue to pray. And then Pastor Herbert, I'll let you sign off to our church family. And when you close, you can say whoever finds God, and we'll say finds life. But I'll give you the final word and dismiss us in the name of the yes. Lord.
Life Church family, we love you so much and love your pastors like crazy. I just thank God for their fearless leadership and the way that you all lead the charge and the influence that you have had on our lives, and that in this critical time in our nation that we can pull together as churches and really make a difference in our hurting world. And so I'm so grateful. Thank you, Pastor Craig and Amy, for your leadership. We love you, love you, love you, respect you, honor you, and we're in this together. Whoever finds God
finds life.